Hello everybody, I just created this very excellent custom print of a composite that I did recently, and I had the immediate thought about how thin the lines are when it comes to fine art compositing and conceptual art and even portraiture. When I had Jürgen in my studio for a portrait shoot, I did some poses where I didn't really look at the background. And I only made sure, in fact, that the hair was in front of the white background, and I ignored everything around it. I just wanted to have a pose, and this was because I wanted to definitively use this image for a composite where I do some location scouting afterwards and look what I find and then combine that. And then sometimes it's just that the pure idea for a composite comes after you shot it. So it took a while, then I did my location scouting and found some interesting locations, buildings and kind of stuff. And then I saw this damaged building and I thought, okay, let's make a natural HDR from the damaged building. And as Jürgen had this pose of looking backwards over his shoulder was a funny expression of, okay, any questions? So this was the title that came up in my mind for this composite. And he said, he didn't say it, but it looked like, any questions? I damage that building, I can damage you if you want. So, and this is the whole story, in fact, behind this composite. And so let's have a look. A run through better. It's not a tutorial, but I give you a short run through how I did it. So, see you in a second. As you can see, it's not the most ideal setting here for a background. I just made sure that I had his hair in front of the white backdrop. I was turning around a little bit around him so that I got the right angle for a future composite. So here we are in Photoshop finally, and we see that I created at first in Photomatics a natural HDR image of this one, where you can see the details in the shadow areas, and it's not comicky or something like that, it's just natural. What I did here was to add a certain sphere, I changed the hue saturation. Then I went on and made it a little bit more vivid by using a curve adjustment layer, and then I took the whole procedure and extracted Jürgen from the one image to this one. And the first step then I took in between was that I wanted to remove the redness that we see here and there a little bit, and I did this with a hue saturation layer, what I clipped to just this layer so that it hadn't any influence on any other layer. And then I just masked out the areas that I wanted to have influenced by this, and then I had the glow effect for the hair so that I show you this so you see the change. I had them set on a separate layer as well. Finally I got a little bit of a vignette around it, and then I put my logo on it, and this was it. Sounds very fast, but it takes a while. So thanks for watching, have a great day, hope you feel inspired, happy shooting. Subscribe to my YouTube channel and please give my Facebook page a like. Very important to let me doing things like this. Thank you very much. Goodbye.